Welcome to RPF. In this video, we'll discuss about how to fill the form using Microsoft Power Automate. So let's run this flow and then I will show you how to build this flow from scratch. Now execution has been started. This will start filling out the form based on the Excel sheet data. So if you can see here, it is entering rigorously all the data which is available into the Excel sheet and submitting the details. So here we have used Excel sheet for data, and from the Excel sheet data, the bot will fetch the data from the Excel sheet and fill out the complete form on fraction of second. So this is very much useful when we have to enter or fill the complete form for multiple user. Till the time the data will be not finished, then it will continue to execute the process and submit the form. Now the data will be finished and we are done with the execution part. So if you can see here, complete data will be filled. And if you want to see the complete stats about this form, we have to navigate it to the response sections, and from there we can see the data is filled or not. So we'll show you how we can see the complete stats. So here in response sections, we can see these all data is successfully filled. So we'll see here how to generate this complete flow from scratch using Microsoft Power Automate, which is a fine RPA based tool used for enterprises for doing their automation need. So this is my Excel file, which contains first name, last name, company name, role in company, address, email and phone number. So by using this detail, our bot will fill the form and then bot will close the file. So let's close this file and delete the complete sections. Now I'm deleting all the steps we have created. So first step, we should have the data. So create the data based on this column, and we have also created this form. So this form will help us to fill out the complete form to store the responses. Now in Microsoft Power Automate, that is desktop based automation tool we are using here, that is called as PAD, Power Automate desktop version. So first steps, I want to drag and drop launch Excel. So which launch Excel file for fetching the data. So we'll drag and drop here, and here we'll use the documentations. As of now, I stored this documents in a download folder, and this is for the read only mode. If you want, we can enable it. Otherwise, we can keep it as it is. It will create the Excel instance variable, and here we are not using any password protected value. So if our Excel is password protected, we have to define the password for this Excel, and based on that it will start executing the process. When we are dragging and dropping any activity in Microsoft Power Automate, this will create auto variable that with the name Excel instance for this activity. Next one, we have to train the bot in such a way this will read the Excel file, read from Excel worksheet, just drag and drop, and now here it will select the exact same Excel instance which is created in previous step. So we want to give the range from which range to which range this bot will read the data. So here we have column A to column G and row 1 to row 11. So Here I will give A, start with column 1. Column G is ending and end with row 11. So first line of range contains column name, so that's why I will enable this and click on save. This will save all my Excel data here. So if I will run and execute the process, I will get all the data will be stored here. So let me execute it. Now this will launch Excel file and you can see 10 rows and 7 columns has been added successfully. Next, we want to launch Chrome or any browser where we want to show the file. So launch browser activity. Now I am using Chrome. So I will drag and drop, and here we have to define the path. So exactly same path we'll use here. Control C and paste it to here, which is my initial URL. And here we have to give the maximized. This will create a new variable with the name browser and click on save. After that, we have set of data. So we have to use the loop. For this, we will use for each. So value to be iterated, here we will give the Excel data variable because we will use this Excel data value to be iterated. Next, we want to populate the value in Excel. So populate text field in form filling. So this is form filling activity which we are using. Here we want to use this one. Now, web browser instance, we are using this UI element. We will add it here. So once I'll click on this, it will navigate into this page. Simply select left click and press control. Now, this will add the variable here, but we want to add the current item. So we'll select this and after that, we will define the name for which name we are going to use. So this name should match with our column name. So here we will copy and paste this name in single quote so that this value will be selected in square bracket. Exactly same thing we have to perform it for the other areas or other columns. Then add UI element and then add the selector for last name. Again, we will use current item and from here we will add last name. Copy and paste this value. Save it. Next, we want company name. Again, add UI element and then current item select. Then add here single quote. Copy company name. Click on save. Again, extract, populate text field on which web page. Add UI element, and this time we'll use role in company. Current item, and then address, item, this time we'll use address, email, again select current item and then add email. And last one is with phone number. Click on save. Now we are done with this. So let me close this. Now, so this flow will run till submission of the form. We have not selected the submit button. So once we'll add the submit button, we will just click on click button activity. So this will click on submit button. Now this is done. And next one, we have to click on submit. So let's save this and run the process. Okay, there is a typo error. So here we will give save it and run it again. Now we have not built the flow for the further steps, so we have to again add one more activity of click. So here we will select click link on web page, drag and drop, left click, and then we will validate on UI. Now our automation is perfect, and this time this will save all the values into Excel. And post that, if you want to close the Excel, we can add the close Excel activity. So here we will add close Excel. Click on save. Now run the flow. Now you can see till the time value is not empty or this bot will not fill all this data, we will continue, or bot will continue to fill out the form till the value, all the values are done. Now this is done and you can see the bot has stopped filling out the form. So that's all from this video. Let's recap. We have started with filling out the form on Google Drive form, and we have added launch Excel, then read the Excel data and add it into form and close that Excel application. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.